duck and the rose.
The duck and the rose. Okay, that's a cool. The duck and the rose. That might be too good of a title for us. It's called The Duck and the Rose. The Duck and the Rose. So we'll do regular scenes, clap-ins, and then we'll have songs. Yeah. This is called The Duck and the Rose. It'll cook up for dinner.
Oh, lovely. And we'll have a big duck for Christmas dinner.
Yes, we will. Where did you get that accent, little Maggie?
I just said that a duck and English accents go together.
I think you're right, too.
Yes, but it'll get all plump and wonderful, and we'll have our dinner.
And I will set the table.
Oh yes, you're such a dutiful daughter.
This time of the year?
Well, yes, it's all the fertilizer I use and constant attention. I'm out here every hour on the hour, day or night.
I love trimming these branches with you and watching the blossoms grow, and I'm sure you're gonna win awards this year, especially this blossom right here. It's so beautiful. Oh, the color is magnificent, the size.
This is called the Red Silky.
The Red Silky?
It's a hybrid that I came up with on my own.
A hybrid. That's what he said, a hybrid. silky rose, how wonderful, a silky rose.
I raised it myself.
How beautiful, a pipe red, you say.
It's going to be a winner at the fair.
I think so. You know, I'm feeling a bit hungry. What do you think? How about a little lunch break?
That sounds like a great idea, Fred.
Sorry, Maggie, it's porridge again. Somebody broke in and took our duck.
I can't believe we lost our duck.
I've heard rumors that somebody has been liberating the ducks with a rose. You know, in this township, near the decrepit forest, if you get a rose near a duck, it's not a myth. They leave.
Wow. And who has roses but Mr. Charnleton?
Dun, dun, dun. But he would never just give someone a rose. They must have stolen it.
Someone's stealing roses.
And our duck.
And setting ducks free.
Someone's stealing roses and setting duck free.
We'll find them, we'll hunt them down, it won't remain a mystery.
We'll cook another duck on Saturday
and set a trap.
Indeed.
We'll catch the thief red-handed.
Which are liberating. Tom doesn't realize it. He thinks it's his fertilizer. But it's a spell that liberates, especially the fowl of the world.
Well, I know. In fact, I've freed a few fowl already.
Well, I hear rumor that they're trying to set an ambush, so you might need extra roses.
Oh, and maybe you can magically exercise them.
I will exercise half a dozen roses for you, and Tom will not even notice.
Okay,
because when I exercise, it will be a hidden cloak. me trim the verge.
The verge?
Yes, I noticed some verge on them this morning. Decimating for a rose garden. Get that verge off. Oh, you must be a master gardener. Excellent, excellent, excellent.
I've read all the roses.
We have to read in this decrepit wood. There's nothing left to do.
Exactly. Reading and sloppily talking. We read and we talk
if we can. If people can understand us.
When you're in the woods with no one else,
it's a man, they demand us.
And then she
went and
Oh, I have an idea.
You too.
Oh, yeah. Okay, okay. We can do this.
We can.
Thank you, magical, mystical Mary.
How's it feel, Maggie? We gave the duck the rose and he's flying off to be with his little duckling friends.
Bye, brother!
You're gonna roast, Maggie. You'll be toast, Maggie.
Put you in a pan, Maggie. Then in a can with what's left over,
Maggie. Quack, quack. How do you feel now, Maggie? I'm getting hot.
I've got the thermometer.
Then stick it
in a fire.
It's touching the bone. It's touching the bone. I hope you hear it.
Get to the bone.
It's touching the bone.
It's touching the bone. Ah, I think I like this part the best.
She looks skinny, not like all the rest.
We can't wait to take you for the test.
Another half hour, and she will be the best.
Cold, but now
warmed up.